Hello and welcome back to my channel www.plasmatweeter.de, and this is a little year end special for you. I have used my time in the last weeks and months and develop something new for you. Yeah, in this world, I am safe, no COVID so far. So for all of you which are out there, I'm living in a little town in the northern part of Germany, and the town has about 500 employees, so it's not big. And yes, COVID is not here, so we are all very glad and hope that it will be also in the new year. So what is up now? I have developed a transistor-based Iono phone. I show you in a minute. I think it's the world first. I never saw an Iono phone based off a complete transistor circuit. So no tube is in. So it's transistor, it's safe, it operates at 22 volts, about 2 amperes, and you can touch it everywhere. You have not to touch the hot quartz cell, you burn your fingers, but it's a really safe device, and it will have a built-in amplifier so that it can be connected directly to your stereo equipment with active crossover or what you need. So I show you this now, and I wish you and your family and your loves all the best, and Happy New Year, and the next video in 2021. Okay, now the world first transistor based Iono phone. So no tube, this is a transistor RF setup, and this here in front is a little amplifier, and we have here the quartz cell. And normally this is the PCB with the tube, so tube is missing. We don't need the electronics here. I am only using the loading coil, which is connected here to our plasma cell, and that's it. Iono phone without tube. But here in the bottom, there is the magic. So this is the transistor circuit. So we have here a normal build oscillator with quartz controls. We have a driver transistor, and we have the RF power end transistor. Give a closer look here. This is how it looks. And this is the L network on the end with a variable cap for controlling the RF section, and that's it. So it runs on 22 volts. So, and we can see the plasma flame is burning. I don't know if the camera can capture this. So there is the plasma flame. Just dim the light a little bit, and then can turn it off, and can turn it on, off, on. And closer look here. There's the plasma flame off. Plasma flame is on. And this is the advantage from a transistor design. I can only power off and on, and the flame starts or the tweeter stops. So this is my power supply, which I'm using here for testing, and it's 22 volts, about 2 amperes of power flowing in. And this is my little amp, which is here connected to the PC, and on the other side it's connected to my transistor design. So I'm using here the official YouTube video music to get no complaints about copyrights from music. So I can start this and here we have volume knob. So the plasma speaker working perfectly. So plasma speaker can connect directly to music source, CD player, or something else. So this is the experimental setup. I will make PCBs for it. Little power down the music a little. So I will make PCB for this, but not now at the year end of 2020. Christmas time, the family is here, and there is no time for twiggling around with the circuits. So the circuit is pretty simple, and the advantage is it's low power, it's 22 volts, you can touch it everywhere, so this is not a problem. And you don't have to touch the quartz cell and the RF part of the loading tube. So the input part is no problem, but I won't touch here the output part because there is high power RF energy. You can see it here. So this is like the tube design. Yeah, big advantage, low power, not dangerous. And the next advantage, you can power on and off like you wish, and it's working perfect. Yeah. So I will make the PCBs, I think, in 2021, January. So I have to twiggle around with PCB program. Normally I use Eagle and the free version, but the free version is the PCBs are only 80 millimeters to 100 millimeters. That's not big enough to make this PCB, so I have to look for another PCB software. So I will see what I can get there for free, and then we'll make PCBs. And hopefully end of January and the beginning or in the mid of February we have complete tweeter and RF in the transistor design. So we need a big heatsink like this one, maybe a little bit bigger. So it's running now 10 minutes. I think it's about 40 degrees or something. This is because the efficiency of these N transistors is not very good. They are about 50% efficiency. So the input power is now 22 volts, 2 amps, about 45 watts. And 50%, we are from 50%, so between 20 and 25 watts is heat. So this is really warm. 40 or 45 degrees Celsius. So to drive this you need not much power. So I have here this little power amplifier. It's a gain claw. So that's about 10 watts. The big coils are necessary for to transport the RF. Also the big condensers are necessary because you need a lot of area to transport the RF to our coil. But it's reliable and it's very, very good to play with it. I'm really satisfied how it comes out now. So, that it was for now. The newest development on the bench. I think really it's the first transistor-based Iono phone. I never seen something like that in the past. Maybe there is something out in the world. I don't know. You can write it in the comments. So, that's for now, our latest update, year-end 2020. So, the best wishes from me for the new year to all. And I think we see us in next year. Bye.